Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Dear Goinkans, welcome back to your Islamic studies class. Today in our class, we will all open our page number 1919. I'll wait for some time. You will all open page number 19 of the book. On that page, you have been given two du'as. One is regarding the increase in knowledge. You should always recite this dua, Rabbi Zidni Ilma, in order to increase your knowledge. And the second dua is, whenever you wish to do something, you should always recite Insha Allah, which means, if Allah wills. Insha Allah means everything happens with the will of Almighty. And when you say Insha Allah, it means you have faith on Almighty and you believe that this will happen only when Allah is willing to do it. Okay, with the will of Allah. So you should always recite this. Whenever you're intending to do something good in life, always remember to recite Insha Allah. Okay. Now, why have I shown this picture here? Why have I displayed it? Today, I will narrate a story based on an incident that is related to this Insha Allah. Once, on Friday afternoon, it was during a Jummah khutbah in a small town, an imam talked about significance of saying Insha Allah. He was telling people that how important it is to say Insha Allah whenever you are intending, whenever you are wishing to do something in future, you should always say Insha Allah. For example, if anyone is going for picnic, he can say Insha Allah, tomorrow we are going somewhere. Or if you are intending to learn something, you can say Inshallah, tomorrow I will learn it. Okay, whenever you are doing any things, you should say Inshallah. Same was the thing narrated by the khutbah by the imam. Okay, the imam told the people that you should always say Inshallah. So many people were present there. After the khutbah, the other day, one of the men, he was walking. Actually, he wanted to buy a cow. So, he went to the cow market. Okay? He went to the cow market to buy the cow. And he was very happy as he was having money in his pocket. He was ready to buy the cow. And on his way, he met one of his friends. And his friend asked him, "Where are you going? Where are you going?" The man said that I am going to buy a cow. He did not use the word Inshallah. That man did not use Inshallah. He just simply said, "I am going to buy the cow." And his friend actually told him that, "Do you remember what Imam has told us? That we should always say Inshallah whenever we are intending to do something. So why don't you say Inshallah, I will buy a cow?" And the man laughed and he told him, "Why shall I say Inshallah? I have this money in my pocket. I know that I can buy cow. Why shall I say Inshallah?" After this, when the man reached the market, he was about to buy the cow. When he checked his pocket, there was nothing in his pocket. All the money was stolen by the thieves. And at that time, the man felt very sorry. He felt very sorry for not using the word Inshallah. And he told that cow merchant that, "Inshallah, whenever I'll be having money again, I will buy the cow." And from that day, that man actually learned the lesson that we should always use the word Inshallah whenever we are intending to do anything in life. So, dear students, I hope this was of some use to you. I will see you all in the next class. Till then, take care. Stay blessed. Fi amanillah.